morning, everyone. My name is Sister Lauren, for anyone who does not know. And I just want to give a huge welcome to all of you. Some of you are here for the first time Well, we're all here for the first time in a while. But I am just happy to welcome all of you here. And I really hope that you guys enjoy the program. I want you to participate as much as possible and have fun as we all learn about God together. All right, welcome.
Thank you. Okay, now we're gonna have our praise and worship, If You Happy and You Know It. How many people knows that? I love that song. Can we participate together? If You Happy and You Know It, you can stand up.
Do I have to?
You gotta do some movement.
Okay.
You ready? I'm gonna stand up too. I love moving. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, wave your arms. If you're happy and you know it, wave your arms. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, wave your arms. Clap your hands, nod your head, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray, hooray. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray, hooray.
Hooray.
If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, shout hooray.
Hooray.
Stomp your feet, raise your arms, nod your head, clap your hand. Say hello. Hello. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That was good, wasn't it?
Yes.
Okay.
So Carolyn, so we have another version, if you're happy and you know it, though, that we want to do, right?
Yes.
So let's try it now by saying, if you're thankful and you know it.
Okay.
Try it again, Carolyn, if you're thankful and you know it.
Okay, let's stand up again.
You all can unmute yourself so we can hear you stomping, and you can unmute yourself.
If you're thankful and you know it, shout hooray.
Hooray.
Thankful and you know it, shout hooray.
Hooray.
When you know it and you really want to show it. If you're thankful and you know it, shout hooray.
Hooray. Hooray.
If you're thankful and you know it, give a wave. When you know it, give a wave. If you're thankful and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're thankful when you know it, give a wave. If you're thankful when you know it, blow a kiss. If you're thankful when you know it, blow a kiss. Know it, and you really want to show it. If you think when you know it, blow a kiss. Thank you. Okay, now we'll be having our opening prayer by Kim Ellis.
Hear me?
Yes.
Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, Almighty, Most High God, we thank you for your presence. We thank you for being here with us. We gather in this room sanctuary to come before you to say thank you, to worship, to praise, to adore you, to study and learn more about you. Father God, have your way in this lesson, in this Zoom church. Father God, in spite of our circumstances, we are so thankful in this pandemic. As we acknowledge your presence, We thank you for being here with us. We thank you for all that are assembled, the leaders, the speakers, the youth.
Daddy.
Please bless everyone assembled. Let us continue to walk with you in all that we are thankful for. Let us do everything in decency and in order as we glorify and magnify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Sister Kim Ellis. Now we'll be having our praise report, small win celebration. I'll start off if no one wants to start. I'm just thankful that I was able to wake up this morning to see another day that I have not seen, that my Father have kept me throughout the days and overnight as I slept in slumber, Lord Father God. I'm thankful for my son, that he's always there for me when I need him. And I'm just thankful that the Lord blessed him with a job that he just graduated from with his second degree. And I'm just so thankful. Does anybody have a praise report? If not, you can write it in the chat. Or you're gonna mute yourself.
So we haven't seen you guys in so long, and we're just excited to know what has God been doing in your life, right? What things, what special things have happened? Because we have not seen you guys. I think it's been July, August, September, October. That's a long time. Now it's November, and we're just seeing you guys. So what has been happening? Share some good things.
And then also
have a birthday. Okay, go ahead, Alexis. You go.
Also, it's almost Thanksgiving and Christmas and my sister and cousin's birthday.
Wow. Thank you. Anybody else? You can write it in the chat. You're gonna mute yourself. Anybody else have a praise report that they would like to share with us?
Did anybody have a birthday in September, October, November? Okay, yes, I had a birthday in November too. Alexis, when was your birthday?
February 16th, but I haven't had it yet.
Oh, okay, it's coming up soon. It's gonna be here pretty soon. Anyone else have a birthday or any special day coming up? Tirsa?
Unmute.
Is it gonna be Jeremiah's birthday?
No.
Oh.
And my brother turned 16.
My brother turned 16.
In October.
October.
Yay. Yes. All right. Yay. Thank you for sharing that, Jeremiah.
Why, it's not time.
Anybody else have a praise report? You can unmute yourself or you can write it in the chat.
What has God done for you all? It's been a while. What does God do in your life? What are you thankful for from God? Carissa, have you any praise report?
No, not really.
Not really? God hasn't done nothing in 3 months?
Okay, so we are moving along. Okay.
Real quick, Sister Carolyn, there's just a couple in the chat, so I'll just read those really quickly. Mariah said, it's almost my birthday in December. Yay, happy birthday when it comes, Mariah. And Madison, go ahead. Madison said, I'm happy about my dog's haircut. Oh man, I wish we could see him. I wish we could see your dog, Madison, with his new haircut.
She's gonna go get
it. Oh, okay.
Her mama want her walking through her house on a video.
Aww. Adorable, or he? Thank you for sharing, Madison, your pet with us. Aww.
It's Oscar.
Thank you for sharing, Madison, your pet with us. Aww.
It's Oscar. Oscar's getting big.
Wow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Now we will be having our scripture reading from Tirsa Johnson.
Tirsa, before you start, I am so sorry. There's one more in the chat and I don't want to forget it. Yarissa said, I'm happy because my brother's birthday was in October. I'm happy because my brother's birthday was in October. Thank you.
As Jesus, I am reading Luke 7, 11 to No, 17 to 19.
No, Luke 17.
11
through 19.
Through 19. As Jesus continued on toward Jerusalem, he reached the border between Galilee and Samaria. As he entered a village, there 10 men with leprosy stood at a distance, crying out, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. He looked at them and said, go, show yourselves to the priests. And as they went, they were cleansed of their leprosy. One of them, when he saw that he was healed, came back to Jesus shouting, praise God. He fell to the ground at Jesus' feet, thanking him for what he had done. This man was a Samaritan. Jesus asked, didn't I heal 10 men? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give glory to God except this foreigner? And Jesus said to the man, stand up and go. Your faith has healed you.
Thank you, Tirsa. Now we'll be watching a video.
This is Thankful, the thankful leper. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus did many amazing things while he was on earth.
It's true.
One day, he was traveling to Jerusalem and was going through a village when 10 men who had leprosy came to him. Now in the time Jesus lived, leprosy was a terrible sickness that could be caught very easily. Because of this, people with leprosy were sent outside of the places that they lived. They were called unclean, and no one wanted to be close to them.
Ah, gross!
But when these men who had leprosy saw Jesus coming,
hey, Jesus!
They called out to him and said, Jesus, have mercy on us. And Jesus saw them and said, go show yourself to the priests.
Oh, yeah, we hear that.
And as they went, they were healed and had leprosy no more.
Whoa, woohoo!
When one of the men saw that he was healed, he came back to Jesus shouting, praise God!
Oh yeah, praise God!
He thanked Jesus for what he had done. Jesus asked, didn't I heal 10 men? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give glory to God except this Samaritan?
Looks like it.
Then Jesus said to the man, stand up and go. Your faith has healed you.
Thank you.
And so the man was healed because he had faith and he was thankful for what Jesus had done for him. This.
Thank you.
Now we'll be having our song of preparation, Thank You, Jesus. If you want to, you can type a number one in the chat.
But what does it have to be about?
This is so
as you listen to the song, every time you hear Thank You,
Jesus,
type a one in the chat. Every time you hear it, just type a one.
But how do you go to the chat?
It's at the bottom of your screen, at the very bottom. If you put your mouse at the bottom, it says chat. You see the word C-H-A-T, the speech bubble with like a speech talking bubble.
I'm not on a computer.
Oh, you're on an iPad. Does anyone know how to find the chat on an iPad? Are you on an iPad?
Yes.
At the top, there's three dots. Hit the dots. And the first word says C-H-A-T.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Thank you.
angel Jesus. Let's give a hand clap for all he have done for us. Thank you, Jesus. Now we'll have our meditation by Elizabeth Duplessy.
Yes.
I'm going to let you go back on anything.
Morning, boys and girls. I am so excited to be with you again on our youth Zoom. Today, our topic, Today, our topic is Thanksgiving in a pandemic. The scripture is taken from Luke chapter 17, verse 11 to 19. We are in the middle of a pandemic. The world that we once knew has changed. Life seems to be harder, sadder, and meaner. Everyone seems to be angry these days, struggling to get along, name-calling, and arguing. Even amid the not-so-great things, what have you been thankful for? What have you thanked God for lately? Have you been too upset or too sad to say thank you? Once you get something that you have wanted for so long, do you immediately stop to thank God for your blessings, or do you forget? Today, we will dive into a Bible story that tells us what we should do in the toughest of times and how having an attitude of gratitude brings you closer to God. After listening to the story, think about which character's behavior you would want to copy. Imagine getting the best gift in the world from the best person in the world. What would you do? It's story time. Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem. Traveling to Galilee to Samaria, he came to a small town. There, he met 10 men. They did not come close to Jesus because they had leprosy, a harmful skin disease that causes painful sores all over the body. The 10 men called out to him, "Jesus, Master, please help us." When Jesus saw the men, he said, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." So the men went, and while on the way, they were healed from the harmful skin disease. It was gone. One of the 10 men who were healed went back to Jesus. He praised God in a loud voice. Then he bowed at Jesus' feet and thanked him. This man was the Samaritan who, despite his people being enemies of Jews and the other 9 probably being Jews too, was the only one who returned to thank Jesus for healing him. Jesus asked, 10 men were healed. Where are the other 9? Is this Samaritan the only one who came back to thank God? Then Jesus said to the Samaritan man, "Stand up and go on your way. You were healed because you believed." When times are tough and things are just not going your way, take time to thank God for his blessings in your life. Thank him for the good that has already happened, what you enjoyed, and all the things you have. Thank him for the tough times that you may be dealing with, because God is using those moments to make you stronger and prepare you for even greater blessings. Thank him for the future and what he will do in your life, because even though you do not know what will happen or the turns life will take, they all work for God's great purpose. Boys and girls, we are in a pandemic. We do not know how long COVID will be around. School as we know it has changed, hanging out with friends has changed, going out about town has changed. But there is great news. God never changes. God's love for us never changes. His peace never changes. We have so much to be thankful for. So stop, take a minute, look around and see what God has done. Be thankful and have a happy Thanksgiving. Thank you for listening to our lesson this morning.
Thank you, Sister Elizabeth. Now we will be having discussions, my Sister Elizabeth.
Does anyone have any questions? Well, I have a question for you guys. When there's something that you want badly and you get it, do you always say thank you immediately? Or do you sometimes forget? Go ahead, Alexis.
I don't want to say this, but sometimes I forget.
That's true. We all do. We all forget.
But Alexis, even if you forget, what can you do? Huh? What can you still do?
After I forget, I remind myself that I still have to say thank you.
Good. Yes, that's good. Arissa, you had your hand up?
Sometimes I forget, but when I forget, I have to remind myself that I have to say thank you.
Can you say that again, Arissa? I didn't catch it.
Sometimes I forget, but at the end of the day, I say thank you.
Very good.
Any other questions? Maddie, you had your hand up? Oh.
Comments in the chat.
Okay.
I say thank you all the time, and I make other people say thank you.
Oh, thank you, Tirsa.
I say thank you.
Mariah said, I say thank you.
What about the leper that came back? Why do you think he came back? Why did the other nine not come back? Like, Jesus healed all of them, but only nine of them just kept going. Why do you think they didn't come back?
Because they forgot to say thank you, or they just didn't want to say thank you.
That's true.
I would say sometimes even when we get something, we like there's a side of us that sometimes think we deserve what we get. So then it doesn't make us grateful because we feel like we should have already gotten it or received it.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's always important for us to understand that every gift is from God, you know, and that we don't necessarily deserve anything, but it's through God's grace that we get it.
Tersa, I think has a hand up.
Every time we get blessed, sometimes we forget how we were blessed.
What do you mean?
I mean, like, we never say thank you Well, every time God makes us, gets us blessed, we never say thank you. We forget how we say, we forget to say thank you to him for blessing us.
Maddie, is that a hand? Can I go back to something Elizabeth said? So she said, sometimes we just think we deserve it. How many of you, I'm not even gonna say today, in this week, did you thank your mom, dad, auntie, whoever lived with you for making you breakfast, for making sure you have clothes? How many of you said thank you when mom can just put breakfast in front of you?
No.
I see two hands, that's good. Because sometimes we think, well, that's what mommies and daddies and aunties and grandmas are supposed to do. So we don't say thank you, but they don't have to. For many kids, they don't have mommies and daddies, and some that do, they don't even get those things. So every meal you have, it's important to say thank you for whoever made it for you. Like little things, I think we forget. We think it's always the big things, but even the little things that mommies, daddies, aunties, they don't have to do it for you, but they do. So it's important that you say thank you, because we don't deserve anything.
Any other questions? Alexis, I feel like you have a question.
You have a question?
Yeah. What was the disease that they had in the scripture? What's the disease?
It starts with L.
Tersa, you can unmute yourself, Tersa. You guys could keep yourself unmuted and just talk. It's okay.
It's called leprosy. Leprosy?
Mm-hmm. What is it?
The disease.
Mm-hmm.
It's a disease like COVID.
It's skin disease.
It's a skin disease? It's a skin disease, right? But I love what Tersa said, because it's like COVID in that once you have it, nobody wants to be near you, right? Everybody runs away from you because it's catching. So they're afraid they're going to catch it, just like people have COVID now and you don't want to be near them, right? Because you're afraid you might get it as well, even when they're just talking to you.
That's why everybody's wearing masks and gloves.
Exactly. People wear masks and gloves. And back then, when people had leprosy, like, they put them on a completely different part. They weren't allowed to live like how we live with our families. And things that they weren't allowed to live with their families. They put them to a separate place where, so it's almost like everyone was afraid of them. They just had to talk to each other. Think about how sad is that? Isn't that really sad? Imagine getting sick and you couldn't see anyone for a long time. And at least with COVID, like, a lot of people do get better. Even if they go to the hospitals, they eventually come back home. But okay. Back then, say that again, Alexis.
Sometimes they die.
Yes, sometimes they do pass away, and it's very sad. And some families have lost their members who do have it. And it's the same thing with leprosy. Some people would eventually just die being far away from their family. So there's a lot of things that are just like it, right? So it's very hard. But one of the things that's important to remember is that even when people are sick, and back then they would treat them really badly, is that even when people are sick, you're not supposed to treat them badly, right? You still want to love them and you want to care for them. Even necessarily, you can't be near them and hug them in the same way, but you want to make sure that you're being nice and kind to people and not just treating them very badly because they have a sickness or disease.
Okay. Okay, Madison wrote in the chat, I thank Auntie when she brings me toys. I lost my grandma.
Both her grandmas with COVID. Thank you, Maddie, for sharing that.
All right, thank you, everyone. Now we'll come to the fun part of our activity. By Sister Lauren Cooper.
Okay, so we are going, I'm gonna share with you guys how to do a little art project. And I just wanna give you a few minutes to see if you have any of these things at your house. So there's several ways that you could do it. And I wanna share more than one way so that you can, all do it with whatever you may have at your house. So maybe you might have a brown paper bag. You have a brown paper bag, you can get that. Okay, but if you don't have a brown paper bag, you can get a plain white envelope. You get a plain white envelope and then color it brown. Or you could just get a regular piece of paper, fold it in half, color it brown. Or a paper plate. Now I only have a big one, it's kind of huge, but you can also use a paper plate for this activity, okay? So what we're gonna actually make is this thankful Thanksgiving turkey, okay? So I have an example here. And so the first step is to write on your bag or your envelope. Right? If you have an envelope, if you're using an envelope for this, write what you're thankful for on the bag or the envelope. So I'll just give you guys a few minutes, right? To get whatever you need, whatever you're going to use, whatever you're working with, crayons, markers, and just start to write what you're thankful for on either a piece of paper. It could be a piece of paper that you fold in half. But make sure that you start writing down here because up here is going to be your turkey's face. So like think of half of the sheet is what are you going to write what you're thankful for. Okay. And if you can't do it now, you can always do it later. Okay. So just write what you're thankful for on your piece of paper or your paper bag. Or if you just have an envelope, you want to turn your envelope into a color it brown and then write similar to what I did here, right? I colored, this is an envelope like you would put it in the mail, but I just colored it brown and I wrote what I'm thankful for. And then up here, I left it so that I could put my turkey face and I'll explain to you in a little while.
Or you can make it look like a real turkey and just like get a bowl, get one of those like paper bowls and you can write down what you're thankful for, then put a cover that can come off and do that. And then you can put a face.
Fancy.
Absolutely. That will be a magnificent project. Yes, you could definitely do that. I mean, you could do this any way you want. I'm just giving you like one example, but you guys could do whatever you want because this is arts and crafts and it's about being creative.
Creative.
Right? So you can make, right. So you can make your turkey any way that you want. And using whatever you have in your house, right? Some of you may have feathers in your house. I had to cut my feathers out of paper, but if you have feathers at home, you could just put real feathers on the turkey, similar to what we saw in the picture. So in order to cut out your feathers, you just need some colored paper. And basically what I do is I just cut in the shape of a feather. I don't know if you guys can see me cutting, but I just cut right in the shape of a feather. This one is not coming out that great, but right, so you cut in the shape of a feather, or you can have mom or dad cut it for you, and then you would just glue your feathers around your turkey wherever you want it to be. So if I wanted to add another feather here, I could just add it right here. Want to put some more feathers, you know, anywhere you want to put your feathers. Okay. And then you always want to make sure that you put on your turkey some eyes, a beak, and of course, because it's a turkey, it has to be a little gobbly thing over here. You need to have a gobble, right? So, right, so this is a project. So the most important part though is that you write what you're thankful for on that, on the bottom part, right? And then you can finish crafting your turkey in whichever way you want. I see those nice colors, Alexis. You got the exact perfect colors for Thanksgiving and for fall. Example of what it will look like when you're done. Okay? And you're not going to be able to
all right.
You know, while we're together, but if anybody finishes this and next time we get together, I would love to see what your project turns out.
Wait, can we stay on until we finish?
Well, it would be nice, but unfortunately we have to get ready for the older kids because the older kids will be coming on soon. Okay, so you can work on it at home by yourself, and we'll make some time at our next meeting, at our next youth Zoom, so that we can share what we made. I'm excited to see you guys, how your turkeys come out.
Is it tomorrow? All right?
It's, well, no, it's about 2 weeks, Alexis, in about 2 weeks.
That's we'll like after Thanksgiving.
But they can share it in our group. They have the group that they can share it in. We need to give them the link if they want. I can, the Google Classroom.
Oh yes, the Google Classroom, right, yes. Oh, nice, Tirza, very good. Okay.
Nice.
Going. Good job.
Can I see it again, Tirza? I missed it. Can I see?
Yo, check my stuff.
Oh, very nice.
Thank you, Sister Cooper.
You're welcome. Thank you,
Sister Cooper. Okay,
thank you everybody for participating.
We'll be having our intercessory closeout prayer request by Lauren Cooper.
Okay, guys, so I'm going to ask everyone to just stop with your craft for a minute, just so we could just say a quick prayer. And as soon as we pray, then you can get back to work. Okay, because I see some of you are very busy bees right now. So let's just do a quick prayer and then we'll move on. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to say thank you, God. We want to collectively thank you for all that you have done for us, God. We want to say thank you right now for every time that we've ever forgotten, Lord. Every time we've ever forgotten to say thank you, we ask you to forgive us of that, Lord, and just remind us and encourage us and put it on our hearts to always remember to thank you and to thank our family, our brothers, our sisters, our neighbors, and anyone that does anything for us, God. Help us to understand that everything that we have comes from you and that we don't deserve anything, Lord, and that we should be thankful every time we get a gift from you. Lord, I ask that you just bless everyone on this line. I just want to say a special prayer for Sister Kim Ellis, who had to get off the call due to a family emergency. We ask that you will bless her, God, and her family. Jesus' name I pray, amen.
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 Now we'll be having a praise out. Just want to thank you, praise.
Oh, share the music.
And ever for
back music.
You done
for me.
blessings and glory.
And honor, they all belong to you. Thank you, Jesus, for
me. Then you can share the sound. You don't have to.
I'm with you, Sister Carolyn.
And ever, and ever, for all you've done for me. Blessings and glory, and honor, they all belong to you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I just wanna praise you
forever, come on.
Forever
and ever.
And ever.
And ever.
And ever.
For all.
Just wanna pray.
Oh.